Get ready to match the stars. Bill Daly, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Three's Company, Jenny Lee Harrison, McLean Stevenson, and Edie McClurg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Yeah, yes, sir. Hi, John.
I just want to take a minute out before we go to Kathy and the big bucks. Yesterday, I made reference to the fact that Jenny Lee was getting too much airtime and with dumb answers and stuff. Most of them are dumb. But I was rude, and I want to publicly apologize for saying that.
Oh. Thank you.
Aww. That's nice.
That is nice.
Yeah. Well.
That's very nice of you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. Now you're getting a lot of camera time.
I don't care about that.
I know that all of you are just jealous, and you're picking on me.
That's
I'm new.
True, Jenny Lee.
Okay, well, we'll try to do equal time for everyone here.
Old people
now,
always hate young people, Jenny.
Here.
You're just a guest.
I'm a guest.
Right. Would you welcome Kathy Schultz? Kathy, would you come on down here, please?
Take the place a little dot there.
Well, we're going to start right now. If you're ready. All right.
It's only 5 months worth.
Really?
Yeah.
Don't come out now. We ain't ready for you.
Gene, she's not pregnant. She's just overweight.
Oh.
Very embarrassing.
All right, here we go.
An extra point.
Now, we poll the studio audience and write down your best answer to this. Blank
really
Salinger.
Are you?
Blank Salinger. Whom do you wish to call us?
Oh.
I guess I want Brett.
Pierre!
Pierre Salinger, the commentator with ABC, yes. Edie's got her hand up.
The reclusive novelist, J.D. Salinger.
J.D.
Nobody
Salinger.
Nobody knows him anymore, sweetheart. God love
McLean?
You.
What?
What?
Were you calling me, did you?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, now he'll think about it a minute. Maybe Jenny Lee will give
He's
him
He's taking
answer.
Up the camera time.
No, I'm not. Now, come on, I said I was...
Jerry Salinger!
Who?
Jerry.
So we have Pierre, right?
We have Pierre and we have J.D.
Right, okay. Carl.
Carl Salinger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's Carl Sandburg.
Everybody knows Carl Salinger, right?
He's an orthodontist in Peoria.
Oh, an orthodontist in Peoria. Okay. Thank you very much. Now, so you have Carl, J.D., and Pierre. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
The first one I thought of was Pierre. So I'll take Pierre.
All right. Pierre it is. Very popular fellow. May we see the $100 response, if you please? Leo Salinger.
Leo?
Who is that?
Leo Salinger.
Carl.
Now, wait a
brother.
Who?
Shortstop.
He runs a delicatessen on Fairfax.
No, he's a shortstop.
In New York?
Play shortstop.
No kidding.
Leo? The floor walker at Broadway.
All right, let's take a look at the next one. J.D., all right. There's Edie's answer.
It's going to be and Irving Salinger.
Irving Salinger, show us your name.
Is.
Go. Yeah. All right. Now, you've got the $500. The least you'll play for is $5,000. But with a lucky spin of the star wheel, you can play for $10,000 if you double it up. Give it a spin. Here we go. Big ones. Here we go. All right. Are you ready? Good luck, my dear. Your job is to match Brett. Here it is. Loss blank.
L-O-S-S, right?
Yeah, that spells loss. L-O-S-S is loss. Am I right about that?
Yeah, yeah, I just couldn't believe that they would do loss.
Well, there's one answer that pops into my mind immediately.
Me too.
You're not going to make it easy for $10,000.
Well, this one seems easy to me. All right. Your job is to match Brett. If you do that, you get $10,000. What do you say?
Loss and gain.
Loss and gain. You drew blank, didn't you?
Yes, I did. Lucky, I said anything.
Gosh, I one of them came right into my head instantly. What'd you say? Loss leader.
Me too.
Loss leader. Loss leader. It's a common phrase in merchandising, and you know when a store advertises.
Loss leader.
Would I be on this cruddy game show if I knew about loss leader? I'd be in business.
No, loss leader.
Like a sensible person. Good gravy, Maria. I'm sorry.
What did you say?
The woman's gonna have a baby and everything. I feel awful. I said loss of a loved one.
Loss of a loved one.
Always thinking about my own family.
That's right, and how to dump them. Right. Loss column. Oh, that's another one. There's some good possibilities here. Loss of memory is another good one. All right, now you've got $500 and a shot at game number two, so let's bring your opponent back. Here comes Kay Stevenson. Let's wait till it stops. Right over here. There you go. Welcome back, Kay.
Thank you.
Here we go with game number two, and you go first, A or B?
I'll try A.
Yes, ma'am. Tough Teddy is really tough.
Not as tough
as he is. He's the only man in the world who uses blank for shaving lotion.
He's tough?
Tough Teddy. Really tough.
It's a pigeon dance.
Ready?
Pigeons dance.
Tough Teddy is really tough. He's the only man in the world who uses blank for shaving lotion.
Gasoline?
Gasoline is a good possibility. Anything like that that would smart your skin when you applied it would be a good response.
I went for a Menin's acid lotion.
Menin's acid. Acid would hurt. That's another good answer.
Now, I want you to think very carefully about this gentleman. I want you to really consider it. Now, there is something in this, and I believe it's a match. Flaming Sterno.
That has nothing to do with gasoline. Yeah.
Well, you see,
she's been drinking Sterno.
And that's telling me what Sterno is, my dear. My mother.
Sterno is when you can't have a baby.
No, dear. That's sterile.
Sterile, yeah.
There is no gasoline in
Sterno. No, Sterno is a jelly-like substance. And when you light and put a match to it, it lights and goes for a long time.
Because it's full of gasoline.
No gasoline in it at all.
It's naphtha.
Something else. Some other combustible substance, but not gasoline.
I want Sterno looked up while I'm sitting here.
All right. We'll bring him in. If you want Sterno, we can bring him in for you.
Mario Sterno.
Oh, wonderful tenor, wasn't he?
What a basketball player.
Fondaldi! He was wonderful.
Now, this doesn't make any sense, but it's sweet.
Yes.
A perfect Rob Roy.
Aha.
Doesn't matter. And
he's the only man in the world. A big reaction.
From the audience.
Yeah. Listen to him applauding and laughing and screaming and hollering there.
Let's not have a rally.
All right.
You and I are the only two people who really know what a
Rob Roy is an old-fashioned mixed drink that little old ladies in Upper Montclair, New Jersey, order when they go to a saloon. Right? Hello there, Jenny Lee. What do you want to talk about?
About my right answer.
What?
Petrol.
Petrol. There it is. One for Kay.
Thank you.
Got a way to go, Kay. Jenny Lee, baby.
See, it wasn't so dumb. Wasn't a dumb answer.
No, it wasn't a dumb answer at all.
I can't tell me no more.
All right, gasoline is what we're after, McLean.
What was the guy's name? Tough what?
Hey, wait a minute.
Tough
I
who?
See by the monitor that she's on over camera here. And you're answering. Well, she's getting...
I got more camera time as usual.
Tough Teddy. I'll just go ahead and answer it anyway.
Yeah.
Nice.
Those are,
just, you're on camera. You got to keep smiling. That's right.
Thank you.
No screaming or anything like that.
If I look off to my right, I won't be on camera at all.
No.
My
business.
All right.
I like it that way.
Okay.
That's interesting.
It looks like those portraits.
Is there
you
room
get at
for my answer?
Yeah, there is room for your answer if you hold it right up under your chin. Oh, there is a question. He's a tough Teddy. He's the only man in the world who uses blank for shaving lotion.
Tough what?
Teddy.
Oh, Teddy. Oh. Sorry. Well, the answer's the same. If you folks can see it, it's gasoline.
Gasoline. Two for K. All right. Edie, you're up next.
Well, I went along with the Larry Linville lookalike, Acid.
Acid. The Larry Linville lookalike. All right, so there we are. Two for her, none for you, and you've got a shot at it, though. One or two shots at it. Now this for you, if you please. Here we go. Kathy, you're round one question. In Las Vegas, Tim said, you know you've had too much to drink when you try to hit the jackpot by putting a quarter in a blank. She's getting more camera time than you are. She's on alone right now. All right.
No, don't get it.
Changing your mind, Bill?
No, I got it.
All right. We'll wait. Okay.
Hurry up, sweetheart.
Here we go, Kathy. In Las Vegas, Tim said, you know you've had too much to drink when you try to hit the jackpot by putting a quarter in a blank.
Lady of the evening? That's the only other thing I could think of that was there.
Really? She said lady of the evening.
Oh.
Yeah.
I said the toilet stall. You know, we hit the...
Oh, yeah. That's good.
You put a nickel in there, you put a quarter in.
Anything like that is good. Oh.
I tried to be a bit more tasteful.
Right.
As you always do, darling. You're magnificent. Go ahead,
true.
Sweetheart.
Thank very you. Tasteful. Thank you.
And she talks so naturally, doesn't
yeah,
she?
Always, that. My mother.
I love your Joan Crawford shoulder. Show us your answer and let's get on with it.
please. Quickly, darling.
Payphone is very good.
Oh, it's charming.
Yes.
Really?
Quite charming. I said pay toilet.
Pay toilet.
Very similar to the first.
Pay phone and pay toilets are both wonderful answers. What'd you say, Jenna Lee?
This is what I meant, but it's in a nicer form. Barmaid.
Barmaid.
No?
Oh, different.
No,
she might be very quiet.
I thought it was
close. No, barmaid.
All right, McLean.
Have you ever made a bar?
Okay, now, am I in that little circle again down on the left?
Yeah. It's okay, the small
I'm
McLean
going
Steve.
To give my answer in sign language. You can say whatever it is you want.
All right.
Hello, everybody out there in TV land. Keep watching. Jenny Lee Hansen show here
whiz.
On Match Game.
I said the cleavage place.
The cleavage place. Oh, that's a marvelous response.
That's a real
cleavage, Ohio.
Answer.
You know what that is. Yes.
I think it's excellent myself.
That's what
sounds like a bar in Ventura, doesn't it?
The cleavage place.
The cleavage place.
Right.
Ask for Harry.
Town in Ohio, Cleavage, Ohio, isn't it?
Cleavage, Ohio. What'd you say, Miss Edie?
Okay, so I was one of those, you know, like, you walk up and down and you walk up and down, and you get real cold and then you get warm and then you get cold and everything. And then I decided, you know, like, I wasn't going to be that no more because it was real stupid. And so, like, I got this really good job. Like, I was, like, serving drinks to this guy over and over and over and over and over again. And finally, he says, jackpot, and he put a quarter in me and I was a waitress.
Aha! All right, so there it is. 2-0 at the end of round one. We go to round two here. And Kay, you're ahead. You have to go first.
I'll try A again.
A it is. Here we go. Have you been to the new Senior Citizens Nightclub?
Not anyway? Really.
No.
Not really. Would you like to hear about it? Well, it's kind of strange. The sign over the door says, not responsible for lost or stolen blanks. Have you thought about it, Kay?
Sure have.
You're about ready? Because we'll be ready in a second. Here we go. This new Senior Citizens Nightclub, Kay, it's strange. The sign over the door says, not responsible for lost or stolen blanks.
Dentures.
Dentures is excellent. All right, Billy Boy.
I'll put my teeth into that one right there. How
teeth.
About that?
All right.
Take a bite out of that.
Three for her.
Oh, college, you whizzicus, criminy dash, wheelchairs.
Wheelchairs. Another good one. Yes.
Hubcaps.
Hubcaps.
From wheelchairs.
Aha. All right. Miss Edie.
Well, I went to one of those,
Senior Citizens.
Senior Citizen Nightclub.
Yes.
I wanted to get down tonight and shake my booty. And in doing so, I flung my face about and
And my dentures landed in someone clear across the room.
Oh, no. Oh, how embarrassing.
Terrible. It was a long-distance hickey.
Dear me. Now, Kathy, you need 4 to tie and 5 to win. Here we go. Say, here's some words of wisdom from the match game.
From the match game?
Yes.
Let me read that. Well, yeah, wait a minute. Yeah.
Word.
Let me read that.
Match game words of wisdom.
Oh, could have fooled me.
Listen to this.
The match game word of wisdom.
Let me have a little quiet organ music in the background. Never rent or echo chamber, anything.
It should be something production.
Never rent your spare room to a guy who has hair growing on his blank. All right, Kathy, you about ready. Here we go. Some match game words of wisdom. Never rent your spare room to a guy who has hair growing on his blank.
I could offend a lot of people, so I'll say teeth.
Teeth is good. Nothing wrong with that. That's a good answer. Yeah. What'd you say, Bill?
I pass.
Play!
Do I have to do this?
Yeah.
This doesn't make any... I haven't had a real good boo. This doesn't make any sense. It's hi-fi set. Boo! Very wise choice. That doesn't make sense at all.
Nothing makes sense. What do you say?
What was that? It's hi-fi set.
I say let me out of here. His wife's chin.
All right. Now you got to match everybody else.
Wait a minute. Mine's not that bad. Wait a minute.
Ray, yeah, sure.
Not that bad.
Holy smokers.
Say teeth.
Palm.
Palm is good. All right, that means Kay wins the game. What do the bottoms here have? Palms, butt, and ears. Come on down, Kay. Take your place on the lead dock there. We'll say goodbye to Kathy Schultz, who's leaving here with $500 and our best wishes for her blessed event. Goodbye, Kathy. Now we've got this message for America.
Of our show, Gene River.
Thank you, John. Here we go with Kay Stevenson. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Ghost of blank.
Ghost.
All right, who do you want for a little assist here?
Brett.
Ghost of a Chance.
Ghost of a Chance is a famous old song.
Bill.
Ghost of Mrs. Muir.
Ghost of Mrs. Muir, right.
And Mrs.
Muir. Edie.
Ghost of Christmas Past.
Aha, uh-huh. Very good.
Ooh.
Ghost of Christmas Past, Ghost and Mrs. Muir, and Ghost of a Chance. You want one of those?
I'll take Ghost of a Chance.
All right, here we go. Let's see if Ghost of a Chance is under the $100 response. Ghost of Sleepy Hollow. The next one says, Ghost of Mrs. Muir. Well, it was Ghost and Mrs. Muir.
Right on that. Who was that young, handsome, tall guy?
It was Charles Nelson Reilly who was on that show.
Wasn't he gorgeous?
Yes, sirree. He was wonderful in it. Wonderful in it. The last one says, Ghost of a Chance. All right, is it $5,000 or $10,000? Let's find out right now. Don't spin it too hard because the wheel has been just oiled. Give it a, well, I don't know. Not that.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
It's a ghost spin.
It has to.
It's got to make one revolution, which it did not. Yeah. Just once around. There we go. Now that's perfect.
Don't let it be me. Don't let it be me. God damn, it's going to be me. What a Christ it's going to be.
Destiny.
I don't think she has a strength.
She has. All right, you're playing for $5,000, and here we go. Good luck to you. Do you have a blank? Do you have a blank? All right, Jenny Lee's made up her mind. It's up to you to match her. How do you do that?
Do you have a dime?
Do you have a dime? Jenny Lee, what do you say?
Now say if I'm dumb.
$500 for Kay Stevenson. Yay! Now this message for you. Thank you all. Gene Rayburn, join us next time for the Match Game. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive... This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. The program is edited for broadcast.